evening, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to bring to the stage my 19-year-old brother, Little Dylan!
Hey everybody, I'm Little Dylan. I'm a 19-year-old blues artist from the San Luis area, and I'm here to talk to you guys today. I got to go on the blues when I think I was probably like 14, 15. I mean, I grew up listening to blues my entire life. I started off singing Don't Answer the Door by B.B. King. It's my first blues song that I learned. And then it kind of branched off from there. Some inspiration that I think about when I was maybe like 14, 13 years old, I was walking through here when the Blues Museum first opened up and I saw the performance space that they had. I didn't know it was going to be a performance space, but I knew it was something. It was going to be something. And I said, I want to perform in here one day. I want to perform in here one day. And I was like, I don't know why I'm like tied to this place. And I was like, I don't know why I'm so in love with this museum. I did my first debut show here with Carolyn Mason. I sang background. And I started to branch off. And this is the place that took me in. This is the place that let me spread my wings. You know, this place was where I played one of my first big scheduled blues shows, you know, and it was awesome. This was something that I would really look forward to, and that keeps pushing me every time that I come here. I feel like I'm starting all over again, and I find that energy all over again, you know. And it's a fire that just it ignites every time that I step into this building and get ready to perform. And some of my biggest inspirations were people like Carolyn Mason, Erica Johnson, my dad Art Pollard, Johnny Taylor, Marquise Knox, Skeet Rogers, Alonzo Townsend. They've been there motivating me, and just a selection of other people like Bobby Bland and Ray Charles and James Brown and all, a little bit of everybody. My goal as a blues musician is to tell my story and to just impact people, you know, in a different way. We, us as blues musicians, as musicians, period, we have the power to make people laugh, make people cry, make people dance, or make them sit and think, you know. And I want my music and me being a blues musician and me having this platform to be a blues musician, I want to impact people. I want to make people feel how I feel whenever I perform, you know. And I think that's how a lot of people, how a lot of blues musicians become very well known, you know, because they perform how they feel, you know. And I want my name to be known as not just Little Dylan, the musician, but as the blues musician who made a difference in today's society. Some of the biggest challenges would be probably like handling a lot of the rejection that I get, whether it's rejection from like winning something or like rejection from like just not getting the gig that I wanted. It's gotten to points where I've even got put out from bars because I was too young. And, you know, I was just going in there just to sing, you know, they didn't want me in there. So I've been talked about because they said that I don't know anything about the blues because I'm too young, you know. I have to face all of that stuff head on and keep pushing and say, I am blues and I know the blues for myself, you know. And it's kind of something that you have to overcome, more of like a mental thing instead of like things around you. In regards to traveling and being a musician, I've done things outside of the country musically, not with blues actually, it was with choral music. I did with my choir, my college choir. I went to Mexico, I was actually in Mexico doing a choir tour out there. And I went to go see, I mean, I was in Puebla City, I was in Mexico City, I was in Teotihuacan, I was all over the place. And it was very awesome, very awesome experience. December 9th through the 13th, I was actually in LA recording for my album, finishing up the recording for my album. And then hopefully in 2020, I could do a little bit more traveling on the southern border and a little bit in the East Coast, the Upper East Coast. So things to expect, let's see. I'm working on an album process, working with some awesome people, some people that you'll soon hear. I'm doing a lot more music things like touring and doing stuff like little small things. But yeah, just be on the lookout, honestly. The advice that I would give to somebody that's my age or younger or older and they have a passion for this, never give up. keep the faith. Honestly, it's more of a faith battle than what you see. There's gonna be a lot of times where you feel like you're not getting anywhere. There's gonna be a lot of times where you feel like you aren't doing anything positive, and you feel like you're just singing just to be singing. But if you keep that going, and you keep that passion going, and you keep that faith going, it'll open a lot of more doors for you than you think. Being you, you know, performing from your heart, you know, performing from your heart will change a lot of things. It'll change the way that people feel how you sing. You know, you can sing some lyrics from a song and it's okay, yeah, but when you start to feel that, other people around you feel it as well. You want to make people feel you in different ways. So if you keep pushing and keep pushing and keep striving and keep bettering yourself, you know, in a positive way, it'll change a lot of things. It'll make you a lot more aggressive and make you hungrier. Just don't give up. Keep the faith, honestly, and it'll all fall into place from there. Thanks again. I'm Little Dylan. Like I said, I'm a 19-year-old blues artist from St. Louis. If you have some time, check out the Blues Museum. Support the Blues Museum. Support local artists. You know, it's a big deal, and this is what we do. You know, we love what we do, so we love it when you guys love it. So come out and check out the Blues Museum.